Hello and welcome back to this Football Manager experiment here with the Sidemen. Now, as you can see, you might not notice it straight off the bat, there's one player short. So I seem to have cocked it up good and proper. fixed the whole 1-2-3. Now, the first two, you didn't seem to find yourself a club. And now it seems maybe you didn't find yourself a club this year. And he's decided to hang his boots up early. And since I didn't think that would be happening anytime soon, I hadn't clicked anything to do with keeping the history after they retire. I can't, like, searching. It's just, like, there's nothing. Nothing at all. So, I've seemed to have royally cut that up. We'll scratch that down. Vic Starr is gone. Couldn't make it in the footballing world. Probably the least likely anyway. But we do have six players still. We've got ZRK to start off with, who looks like he's done the worst sort this season. Sorry. So let's jump straight on in. He is with Bradford still. Let's see. No, still no major career milestones. He's made 15 appearances this season. That's not too good. And a 6.64 average rating, that's very poor. He's got the one assist there. Not too good on the stats. I think that might have even went down compared to last season. Because it looks very average. Very average indeed. Let's have a little look and see how Bradford done. 11th in League One. Okay. 11th in League One. Slap bang mid-table. Nowhere near top. Not really threatened to being relegated. Nothing too grand from them. He's on the bench. It says 17 appearances there. I'm sure it says 15. No, oh, that's across the ball. So, not too good of a season for him. Let's double check, because we did notice he's had some issues with fitness injuries. So, so he had his major one last year. He got a knock in a match. Tight thighs, so that's nothing really. He had a moderate knee ligament. I kept him out for a couple of weeks. And then another slight and a minor, a couple of days each there, nothing too much. So he's not really had any major issues injury wise since the one last season, so he's not doing too good for himself. He'd probably be the next one to fall off unless he can have a big bit oomph about himself in this next season. 27, he's hitting peak time. It's now or never, essentially, what we'll see. So he has KSI. And as you can see there, on the career milestones, winners of League 2. I forgot what league it was there. So he did stay with Exeter. He wasn't snatched away. He won it this time round. And he's wanted by Preston. We'll have a little look at Preston, see where they are in just a moment. 44 appearances in League 2. I think that's every single game. 5 goals, 11 assists. The centre of the park, that's very good. 6.73 rating. I think we'll get a better rating than that. 11 assists from the midfield, 5 goals. That's not too bad at all, if you ask me. So, that is a very good season, I would say, for him. How well did they do to win the league? That was a tight one there with the top two, Exeter and Colchester, but they were guaranteed automatic promotion. Absolutely fine for automatic promotion. Winning the league, coming out as champions and winning the league must be absolutely tremendous. And he is wanted by Preston. Let's have a little look, see where they are. In the championship, so that would be another little up for him. Can't see what I will not do that, because I think there's people in the championship. So In the championship he's wanted, that's not too bad. Not too bad at all. That's another up. It's a big step, I'd say, from League 2. Getting promoted, staying in League 1 would probably be alright for him, but then jumping to the championship straight away. We'll see. We don't know what's going to happen. We'll have to find out what's going to happen there. His stats looks quite good. You got a couple of 19s there, concentration, bravery, and everything else, leadership, and then everything else is sort of average. Good stamina and strength, but the rest of it, it's not grand. It's not grand at all. It's okay. I think the jump to Preston may prove to be too much if he does make that jump. We'll just have to wait and see what does happen with him. If I was at 300k, that's a good little wedge there, 2.5 grand a week. I wouldn't scoff at that at all. I'm sure he would. I'm absolutely sure he would, but myself, I would take that in a heartbeat. So we'll move on to Mini Minter, who's also wanted, and that is by Huddersfield. Now, are they still Premier League? We'll have to wait and see. With Brentford in the Championship still. But his first senior goal, internationals and everything, nothing changed there. We'll have a look at Brentford in a second. 36 appearances, 8 goals, it's getting better. I'm sure last season, how many goals did he score last season? No, I thought that was better, that's worse. That's not very good. Whoops. Not very good on his behalf, on his half there. 6.7 rating, again we've just seen that it is down. He is, I would say, very good physically. Not too bad technically. I don't think he could make a Premier League level. He might be able to go up with someone. I don't think he's going to make it in the big boys. Nothing too tremendous. Who was wanting him? Huddersfield, we're seeing that. And where is Huddersfield these days? They're in the Championship too. So he's not going to be making that big of a step. I was meant to have a look and see where Brentford are in the Championship. 8th. So it's very close. This might ruin it for the other one. Brentford 8th, Huddersfield 7th. 3 points in between them. Huddersfield's got a much better goal difference. Seems to be averaging the amount of scoring goals when winning. It's not too bad, he's a starter. He definitely needs to get his foot behind more goals. Definitely needs to get some more goals. It's not too grand whatsoever. He's on 11.5 grand a week. If only, yeah. Value that 1.8 million, so he's definitely on the verge. I'd say he's top half championship. I don't think he's going to make it as a Premier League striker in the slightest. We'll move straight on here to Rota Shaw with Mansfield in League 2. And he is valued at 200k. He's got a 6.94 rating for the season. Shouldn't be too bad. Looks a bit better. There's a lot of green. It's very bang average. Got his first senior goal this season. Maybe it was last season. I just didn't notice. It must have been last season. 34 appearances, 86% of his tackles won. Probably wants to up that a bit more. It's not, I wouldn't say that's too shabby. What's this one? Dribbles made a game, you don't want that to be too high for your centre back. Tottenham up quite a few yellow cards. I'd say it's part of the game for a centre back, to be fair, yellow cards. It's probably when you start seeing that hit double figures you want to worry. 6 yellow cards in a full season? I don't think that's too bad. You're gonna, like I say, it's part of the game. So 34 appearances in League 2. So he's missed out on 10 games. Well, 9, because he's came off the bench for 1. Has he had any issues with injuries? Did have a major one. Well, 6 weeks he was out for. That could be, I could have come for most of them games. Broken ribs. Not grand. He hasn't had any other than that. Nothing huge. 6 weeks is a long time, but it's not major. Really, well, obviously it is, but it's not. Not too bad. Could have been worse. Could have been months and months. So he's done alright for himself. He's not wanted by anyone, but I still think he could be a very good pickup for someone in the League One, or maybe even lower end championship. Definitely. So yeah, 1.9 grand a week, 200k value. Not too shabby. We'll jump over to Bazinga so we can check out Mansfield. I know obviously we'll go up normally, but he's also Mansfield. So we'll be able to check out how they're done in the league. First senior goal was out this season. I think that might have been this season. If not, well, I'm an idiot, so I'm going to let myself get away with it. 35 appearances this season, 1 goal, 3 assists, 5 player of the matches, and a 7.05 rating. Very good season for him, I would say so. 82% of your titles won, dribbles per game at half. Depends how the, you know, I don't know how the manager's playing him. I'd like me, especially. He's got good pace, well, he's got decent pace for League 2 especially. Good stamina. Good dribbling, good crossing. I would want him up and down, definitely up and down. But we don't know how he's being played. We'll have to just, you know, nothing we can do about that. 5 player of the matches though, 7.05 rating. Has he had any injuries? This is something we should have probably been checking out. Nah, 4 weeks there, biggest one. Twisted ankle, it's not too bad. How many? He's missed out on about 6 or 7 games. It's not, you know, it's not too bad to be fair. Let's check out how they've done with Mansfield, how they've helped them out. 11th in League 2, you just probably spotted this when we were checking out Exeter. 11th in League 2, 67 points. They need a big big bit oomph to get themselves into the top of the table. And about, you know, 10 points and they'll be top 4. I see that's definitely achievable with the right signing. We'll just have to wait and see how they do. And Bazinga's also not wanted by anyone, but I definitely think he could be doing better than League 2. Valued at 200k, same as Rota Shaw. He's on 2.3k a week, which is, you know, very close to the winners of the league. He could be jumping up to the championship. Let's jump into Tove Jizzle, who decided he was staying with Cardiff. If you remember, he was wanted by Arsenal at the end of last season when being relegated with Cardiff. But as you can see in the bottom right corner, and you would have seen when we were checking out Brentford, Cardiff were promoted this season. Not as champions, but a promotion is definitely a promotion. 30 appearances in the league, 8 goals, 5 assists, not too shabby whatsoever, 6.95 rating. I definitely wouldn't scoff at that. 3 dribbles a game, that's more like it, I'd like to see a bit of that. So yeah, 8 goals, 5 assists, you probably want to see more assists than goals from that position. But if he's getting the goals in, you can't complain at all. We're having any issues with injuries over on this side. So he's just had a big spell end of the year and then end of last year and then towards the end of the season there he had 7 weeks out, and at the end of the year he had 4 weeks out, and that was after the Christmas, so he definitely wasn't hoping for a nice Christmas off. So that's 2 major injuries, broken wrist, twisted ankle, totally unrelated, so there's nothing I don't think there is to worry about there. Let's double check Cardiff in the league. League table. Second, nowhere near top place, Fulham with 104 points. They were close to third, but they've obviously clearly done plenty to keep themselves safe there in the second spot and secure automatic promotion. Not a whole lot to worry about, and he is wanted by Southampton. Now, where are they in the Premier League? 14th, not too far off, bottom spot is my little club, Newcastle. Could be happening again this season. That could be exactly what's going to happen this season, if they don't fuck their ideas up. But let's move on from that. What about Southampton? They're not too far off bottom. It could be just what they need to stay up. But if Arsenal couldn't tempt them away, maybe Southampton can't tempt them away. We don't know. Let's leave this here. I hope you've thoroughly enjoyed it. Might be rambling on too much for you. If you don't like it, you don't like it. Just let us know what you think I could change about any of this, any of these videos. A little bit of constructive criticism is not scoffed at over here. I'd love to hear what you think. Drop a like, subscribe to the channel. Like I say, let us know your thoughts. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time.